Hello, we are the SpaceX fans and welcome to the SpaceX Show, the place where you can stay up to date with everything SpaceX. On Tuesday, SpaceX successfully launched their 56th Falcon mission of the year with the launch of Starlink 15-4.
One, ignition, and liftoff of Falcon 9. Go SpaceX, go Starlink.
The booster which launched this mission, B-1088, then landed successfully for the sixth time on the drone ship Of Course I Still Love You.
Stage 1 landing leg deploy.
Also on Tuesday, SpaceX successfully launched their 57th Falcon mission of the year with the launch of Starlink 683.
One, ignition, engine full power, and liftoff. Go SpaceX, go Starlink.
The booster which launched this mission, B-1067, then became the first booster to land successfully for a 28th time on the drone ship. Just read the instructions.
Stage 1 landing leg deploy.
On Wednesday, SpaceX successfully launched their 58th Falcon mission of the year with the launch of Starlink 667.
1. Ignitions, engines full power, and liftoff. Go Falcon, go Starlink.
The booster which launched this mission, B-1090, then landed successfully for the fourth time on the drone ship A Shortfall of Gravitors.
Stage 1 landing leg deploy.
On Friday, SpaceX successfully launched their 59th Falcon mission of the year with the launch of Starlink 15-5.
1, ignition, and liftoff of Falcon 9. Go SpaceX, go Starlink.
Stage 1 propulsion is nominal.
The booster which launched this mission, B-1093, then landed successfully for the second time on the drone ship Of Course I Still Love You.
Landing leg deploy.
SpaceX posted some information about the last Starlink launch we saw. They said Falcon 9's first stage lands on the Of Course I Still Love You drone ship on our 400th Falcon 9 launch with a flight-proven booster. This coming week, we can hopefully expect to see a bunch of Starlink missions launch. The first of these, the Starlink 1215 mission, is currently scheduled for Tuesday 20th at 4:40 a.m. UTC or 12:40 a.m. EDT. Later the same day, and we should see another Starlink mission launch. The Starlink 1116 mission is currently scheduled for Tuesday 20th at 10:42 p.m. UTC or 6:42 p.m. EDT. Later in the week, and we should see another Starlink mission launch. The Starlink 171 mission is currently scheduled for Saturday 24th at 5:14 p.m. UTC or 1:14 p.m. EDT. Then, later the same day, and we should see yet another Starlink mission launch. The Starlink 1222 mission is currently scheduled for Saturday 24th at 6:19 p.m. UTC or 2:19 p.m. EDT. SpaceX may soon start working on a new launch pad for Falcon launches. This post says, as expected, SpaceX will demolish most of the legacy hardware and buildings from Delta IV Heavy and Space Shuttle at Space Launch Complex 6. SpaceX will still use some buildings like the HIF for rocket integration. Heading to Boca Chica, the Pad B OLM was seen being prepared for the lift. Then during the week, SpaceX finally lifted the Pad B orbital launch mount onto the legs. SpaceX recently attached some water bags for Pad B chopstick testing. The Pad B chopsticks were then load tested. The tank farm was recently seen doing a bunch of testing. A trench was seen being dug out the front of the high bay. SpaceX are continuing to demolish the front part of Star Factory. Here's a look at the construction of the houses at Starbase. The B-18.1 test tank was recently rolled over to Massey's test site for some testing. There was a post related to Raptor 3 development and testing. It says Raptor 3 SN number 20 headed to the Raptor South test stand at SpaceX in McGregor, Texas this afternoon. Seems like Raptor 3 is moving along quickly with testing. During the week, SpaceX attempted and aborted an initial Ship 35 static fire test. SpaceX posted a video with pictures of Starship 35 performing the static fire test. They said Starship completed a long-duration 6-engine static fire and is undergoing final preparations for the night flight test. Musk posted some information about a talk he will give before the next Starship launch. He said, just before the Starship flight next week, I will give a company talk explaining the Mars game plan in Starbase, Texas that will also be live streamed on X. Musk gave some information that they still want to try and catch a Starship vehicle this year. He said, later this year, if fate smiles upon SpaceX, the ship will be caught by the tower just like the booster. Jeff Faust posted some information about the next Starship launch. It says the FAA says that it has approved modifications to SpaceX's Starship launch license ahead of its next mission, Flight 9. However, SpaceX can't launch until either the FAA closes the Starship Flight 8 mishap investigation or makes a return to flight determination. Here's a look at Starship 37 being worked on in Mega Bay 2. Also being worked on in Mega Bay 2 is Starship 38. Booster 14-2 was recently rolled to the launch site. It was also lifted onto the Pad 8 orbital launch mount. Then they removed it not long after and rolled it back. As always, I have to say thanks to Jack Beyer, Cesar Garcia and Jerry Pike for being out there filming the Starbase content. Also thanks to the NASA spaceflight team working behind the scenes on their videos, live streams and other space content. That's it for this episode of The SpaceX Show. I hope you enjoyed the video. If you did, make sure to hit the like button and leave a comment down below. If you want to stay updated with SpaceX info, make sure to subscribe and press the bell icon to get notified when I upload. Thanks for watching and have a great day.